Hi guys. So some of you guys may already know from the Instagram post that I posted yesterday, but it has been exactly 1 week since my family and I lost our dog. So I don't remember how many times I showed my dog on my channel or talked about him, but I had a 14-year-old rat terrier. And we actually got him as a puppy. My sister and I received him for a birthday gift when I turned 8 and my sister turned 12. And he was the most well-behaved, loving, caring, strongest, and goofiest dog that I've ever met. The 14 years that he lived with us was just full of wonderful memories. Every time that I was feeling down or was having a rough day and would come home, just looking at him would always make me feel better. He would always greet us with love and affection, and it's been a really tough week, so we had to put him down because he had a lot of complications and he was very old. Like I mentioned, he was 14, and they recommended us that it would not be healthy or good to put him through any other surgery or anything like that, so we had to make the very hard decision to put him down. And I didn't have anything planned on what I wanted to say in this video, but I did want to talk to you guys because I didn't upload a video last week. I know I had some of you guys asking me if I was going to react to CNCO's song, but it's just been really tough. So I hope you guys understand. And I also wasn't able to just come back on here and film happy videos because that's not how I was feeling. And, you know, not every single part of my life is good and happy. I do go through stuff and I just wanted to share that with you guys. But yeah, basically on October 24th, he got really sick and he didn't eat for a couple of days. And then we found out that he had diabetes. And the week before he passed, which was November 2nd, he actually ate really well. He really loved eating apples and carrots. And that day he ate carrots. And he was actually at our kitchen table waiting for us to give him food, which he hadn't done for over a week. So we were really hopeful. But then the days following, he started going downhill again. He stopped eating, and since he had diabetes, it was important for him to eat so that we could give him insulin and his glucose levels were, you know, like leveled and he didn't get sick again. He also didn't want to drink water, so that's when we noticed that things were getting pretty bad. So on Sunday, we made the decision that we were going to be taking him to get an ultrasound the day after, which was Monday. So after he got his ultrasound was when we found out that he had many complications that we weren't aware of. We didn't know also where they came from or what caused them. And the doctor who made the ultrasound kind of told us that the best option would be to put him to sleep so that he wouldn't suffer. And also it was just obvious that he wouldn't be able to live much longer without eating or drinking water. So that's when we made the decision. But thank you so much to everyone that has reached out and sent a comforting message. I really, really appreciate it. And for those of you guys who have your own pet, you know how special and how they become a part of the family in such a short amount of time. And Lucky was not just my pet. He was my son. He was family. He went through so much with us, And everyone that got to meet him fell in love with him. He always greeted everyone with affection. And it's been really hard adjusting to life without him. I didn't think I would be filming this year, especially after how tough it's been. But I think one of the hardest parts of this whole experience has been the fact that life keeps going on. And I feel like we live in a very fast-paced life. Every day seems to just fly by. And as you guys know, I'm currently doing my last semester of college. So I have so much on my plate, and I just feel like I haven't been able to take the time to grieve his loss. I don't know if that makes sense, but I hope you guys understand like where I'm coming from. And it's been really hard to stay positive and stay strong throughout this whole year with everything happening. And he just gave me a lot of strength during this time when I just felt like giving up. He was there to just motivate me. And I will never forget that. That's one thing that I will forever appreciate. And I have put together a video of some of my favorite moments with him that I would like to share with you guys. But I think I'm lost without you.
Lucky, come on.
Strong for so long, I never thought how much.